And I dream in the morning that she brings me water. And I dream in the evening she brings me wine. Just a poor man's daughter from Puerto Peñasco, south of the border in old Mexico. There's a great hot desert south of Mexico. If you don't have water, you better not go. Tequila won't get you across that desert to Evangelina, old Mexico. The fire I feel for the woman I love is driving me insane, knowing she's waiting and I can't get there. God only knows that I rack my brain to try to find a way to reach that woman, old Mexico. Guarded the border. He said you don't need papers, I'll let you go. I can tell that you love her by the look in your eyes now. She's the rose of the desert, old Mexico. And the fire I feel for the woman I love is driving me insane. Knowing she's waiting, I can't get there. God only knows that I left my pain to try to find a way to reach that woman, old Mexico. When I dream in the morning, she brings me water. And I dream in the evening, just a poor man's daughter from Puerto Peñasco, south of the border, old Mexico. Evangelina, I miss you so. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Clean living, pure thoughts, that's all it takes.
I asked Hoyt backstage if he would do a routine. I haven't done this in a long time. It's one of my favorite routines that you do. And it's a story about Roy Rogers and Dale Evans.
Two of my favorite people in the world.
And I know you know them.
Yes, I do.
What was it Dale said to you?
Oh, the last time I saw Dale Evans, she looked at me and she said, you look like the kind of man who would wear suspenders with belts. And that's what I had on. I had suspenders and a belt.
All right. Could you reprise the story for us?
I'll try. Seems that Roy Rogers, king of the cowboys, was out by the Apple Valley Inn. He was riding on Trigger, just riding around in the desert, and he had on some brand new boots. Now, Ralph, these boots were silver and gold and red and green and purple. I mean, they had every color you can think of. They were beautiful boots. Everywhere he rode, the little furry creatures in the desert had to hide their eyes. These boots were so shiny. And all of a sudden, as he's riding around, from out behind a big rock, jumped a mountain lion. It was colorblind. Grabbed hold of Roy by the leg and started chomping on his brand new boots. He was the king of the cowboys, took out a silver shiny six-shooter, bap, right between the eyes. Mountain lion rolled over. He threw this mountain lion up behind the saddle on the horse and rode back to the Apple Valley Inn. And as he rode up, Dale was waiting on him out on the porch.
How was she dressed?
Dale had on some little white boots with little kittens' faces on the toes. Little eyes would move when she walked. And she had on a buckskin friend dress, had little wigwams and teepees on it. And she had a satin blouse with stagecoaches running all over it.
Right.
And she had on that blonde wig that, who was that girl? My first wife looked like her. That's why I married her. Connie Stevens. She had on that wig that Connie Stevens wore in that Hawaii movie she did with Troy Donahue.
Yes.
And as Dale saw Roy come riding up to the Apple Valley Inn with that mountain lion over behind the saddle, she looked at him and she said, pardon me, Roy, is that the cat that chewed your new shoes?
That's cute. I love that. By the way, later on, during the audience segment, we have been auditioning some young ladies, or I don't know what ages they are, but some ladies. And the winner of the audition is going to play opposite you in a little skit.
Mm-hmm.
About Romeo and Juliet.
Yes, sir. I'm going to play Romeo.
Oh, are you? Let me hear that line.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
Well, that's her line.
That's her line.
What does he say?
He says, you want some candy, little girl? I'm not sure what he says. It's scripted, though.
Okay. Now, that'll be coming up during the audience segment. How about new movies for you?
I have three movies that I've done that are, as they say, in the can. They're finished but unreleased. One of them I described to you last year, I think, Space Case.
Yes.
With Ray Walston, who played my favorite Martian.
What else?
I just wanted to mention something about Ray. He's wonderful. Ray's 75, but he'll only admit to 67.
What was the character he played in that television show?
He played my favorite Martian.
Okay.
He played the Martian.
Okay.
And I think it was typecasting. He's a great guy. I don't mean to cast any aspersions.
All right, what other new movie? What is Nobody's Sweetheart?
It's the best acting I've ever done. As far as having a good time and enjoying a role. It's a story of two little girls who are best friends in western Montana in 1946. And one little girl's dad comes back from the war and the other little girl's dad doesn't. And it's about, you know, their coming of age in 1946. What a sweet, innocent time it was, even though we'd just been through the worst war we'd ever had. And I played the little girl's grandfather. The girl is played by a beautiful little actress named Nicole Tom.
Who else is in the picture?
There's a girl named Betty Ford, plays my wife in the film, and she was one of the world-class bullfighter back in the 50s and 60s.
Will this be out? Does this have a release date?
Well, Disney's looking at it right now. They did the film privately with private funding, and now they're looking for the distribution. And Disney, if you're listening, distribute this movie, friends.
Well, I'll look forward to that. Let me take a break here.
Caught my wife with another man, and it cost me 99. On a prison farm in Georgia, close to the border line. I've been here for 12 long years, finally the warden, my friend. So he sentenced me to a life of ease, taking care of old Red. Old Red, he's the baddest dog I have ever seen. Got a nose that can smell a two-day trail. He's a four-day tracking machine. Can't consider yourself mighty lucky to get past the beers and the quicksand beds. All these years that I've been here, ain't nobody got past Red. Hear the warden say, come on, somebody, why don't you run? Old Red kitchen to have a get my ladder, get my gun, better have a drink for the party. off a guard and I slipped out a letter to my cousin up in Tennessee. He brought down a blue tick hound. She was pretty as she could be. Well, they pinned her up in the swampland about a mile just south of the gate. I'd take old Red for his evening run. I'd just drop him off and wait. Hear the warden say, come on somebody, why don't you run? Old Red Ditching. Used to seeing his lady every night. So I kept him away for 3 or 4 days, waited till the time got right. I made my run with the evening sun and a smile when I heard him turn red out. 'Cause I was headed north to Tennessee, old Red was headed south. Hear the warden say, why don't you run? Now there's red-headed blue ticks all over the South. Love got me in and love got me out.